No, not too many people write about programs that don't succeed. So it's kind of hard to find those. I'm sure there are some out there. You know, I definitely am. But like I said, I don't think that this strategy alone is going to get us where we need to be. I definitely understand the 5-year sustainability issue, and I think that one is a question that we have to really tackle. Because we don't have an answer for that right now. Like, you know, I have a list of questions that came up from the meeting that I can answer almost all of them from, you know, the parents. That sustainability question I can't answer, and you know, and I can't answer your question about, you know, programs that didn't succeed. We weren't really looking for them either, to be honest. Well, you know, we wanted to look and see, does this work, not does it not work, right?
In that particular area, and then the last question basically talks about that computer. Even though it's at $150, you got insurance, you got the bag and all of that, but if it was donated free, why is there still a cost to it?
So I'm glad you brought the computer up, because I didn't speak about that. So what she's talking about, two of the things that we are doing in year one are implementing technology initiatives. And those initiatives are basically to bring technology into the homes of our students. So all kindergarten through first graders will get, it's called one laptop. It's a real small, durable laptop. It's not something that you find on a consumer market. But what it is, it operates on a platform called Sugar. And I just like the name, but I couldn't tell you anything about Sugar. I've played with it, and essentially they are learning games. So it gives the kids an opportunity to learn how to navigate a computer without navigating Internet Explorer. And I sat down with the project manager for One Laptop, and I said, well, does it make sense to introduce them to Sugar when they're going to move on to a different operational system later? And the principles of Sugar are the same. So the goal is to get them, to get our first through fourth graders able to point and click, move around in the computer small enough for the hands. And so the goal is not to introduce them to the technology that we have right away, but to provide them with a basic foundation and principles. The other part of that is all Project L.I.F.T families can purchase a netbook computer for $150. And with that comes internet access for a year. And it's not like it's in their home, it's actually in the computer. So wherever they go, the internet access goes with them. And the thought is that after having it for a year, you know, the research shows that they will provide or pay for it on their own. So to your point, Blanche, we are subsidizing, actually Project L.I.F.T is subsidizing the cost of that computer. So it's not being donated for free. We're actually paying the other part of the cost for that. So, you know, the computer bag and the insurance, like, we want them to put something, you know, put some skin in the game themselves. So at some point, you know, we're giving you something, but we can't give you everything. So, you know, part of it is personal responsibility. If we're asking you to put up, I mean, it's $150, that's not a lot of money. And why year-round didn't work at Brunn's? The story that I'm told is that it was a magnet program. And when the magnet programs went away, so did this year-round program at Brunn's. But it was a great program from, you know, and like I said, I don't have anything to verify any of this. But this is the oral history tradition. This is the story that was told. That it was, you know, it was also not the same student there, so it was busing. So the students at Brunn's didn't look like the population, didn't look like this population. So we couldn't compare that to what we're proposing. Well, we had to ask for special permission to add days to the calendar. We could have done year round without going to the state legislature. We had to ask for special permission to add the days to the calendar. So they're saying you could do year round with 185 days, but adding that time and the cost that goes along with that, we're not paying for that. And so to your point, Blanche, it will be costly. And so that's another consideration that we're taking and that we're looking at, as well as, do we do it in all of our schools? Is it feasible to do it at a high school? So we've heard that concern, and we are really looking at, is this really going to work across all of our schools? So I'll definitely tell you, that's a challenge. It was brought to me at the end of September, and I mean literally like the last 2 weeks of September. In October, we're gonna have these meetings. And so I pulled the meetings together, and we did them every Thursday in October. And so I was like, we need more feedback. The survey was that. But we have to know whether or not we're moving forward by December 11th. So at this point, it's going out and speaking to as many people as possible, trying to get them to take that survey. It's going to the schools, having conversations with parents, going to beauty salons and barbershops, which I have done, to have that conversation, to say, did you know this was going on? It's asking all of you to continue to have that conversation. You know the survey is there now. Send people there. Tell me where I need to go to continue having this conversation. But by December 4th, we're coming back to the community with what our recommendation is, and by December 11th, we're either going to the board or not going to the board with a recommendation.
Okay, Beverly, why don't you give us Brandi, give us the website, then if you want people to go to the website to answer the question.
It's projectliftcharlotte.org. So it definitely is a challenge, and I agree. I'm not happy with 33 people per school. We definitely had more people than that at certain ones, but yeah. I'll tell you, the technology initiatives that we're doing are ours. One laptop has been implemented other places, but this Shape the Future program is something that we've worked with Microsoft to build. And the goal of that is to get technology into every home. CMS is looking to move to bring your own technology to school. And so we are hoping to make sure that our kids don't get left out of that. And so that is, really this first year of implementation, we're focusing on technology. So those two things and then providing great teachers in the classroom, those are what we're focusing on. So right now, what we've implemented and what we're considering implementing are, the technology initiatives. There are some other things that we're looking at coming up. One of the things in year two that Denise has talked about is how we address the social issues that impact students. So if we get the academics right and the technology piece right in year one, then let's deal with some of the things that happen outside the classroom that impact what goes on in the classroom. And what does that look like? So we've talked about, a community school model. We've talked about putting more social workers in school. How do we invest the money in a way that it will really impact students? So I can tell you that those ideas will be a combination of best practices and what we've heard, from the community.
And what about L.I.F.T. Academy?
L.I.F.T. Academy is definitely homegrown.
That was Denise's idea.
Yeah, that was Denise's idea.